The United States is home to many of the best athletes in the world. The culture around athletics is unmatched, which leads to international talents arising every year. Athletes like Sydney McLaughlin, Noah Lyles, and Uthing Mo are the current leaders for the track and field world. But before any of these athletes were even born, one man was blazing a trail on the track. On September 13, 1967, the greatest athlete of all time was born, and his name is Michael Johnson. As one of four children from parents Paul and Ruby Johnson, he and his siblings quickly took to sports. But unlike his siblings, Michael turned to running. His reasoning was that in track, he didn't have to rely on anyone else. Everything he achieved would be because of his ability, and clearly his ability would take him far. His first experience with track and field was in junior high. Although we know him as dominant today, it wasn't the same story back then. Johnson was no immediate phenom, which was actually a good thing. Enjoying his years on the junior high track team, but not excelling led him to focus on school during his freshman and sophomore years of high school. And since he enjoyed running so much, in his junior year he tried out and made the track team. Growing up in Texas, track was a big deal, but Johnson's coach Joel Ezer gave the advice to just enjoy running, which caused Johnson to never get burned out. As a senior, Johnson won the district 200 meters dash, but came up short of the state title. This earned him his spot on Clyde Hart's Baylor track and field team, where he would start to evolve into the athlete we know. In his first race as a collegiate athlete, Johnson broke Baylor's 200 meters record with a time of 20.41 seconds. In his 4 years at Baylor, Johnson won 5 NCAA golds. These came from 3 200-meter wins and 2 4x400-meter wins. These wins foreshadowed his insane dominance that was about to come. In 1991, Johnson won his first world championship medal in the 200 meters by 0.33 seconds, which is extremely rare in the highest level of competition. The next year was the 1992 Barcelona Olympics, and Johnson was the clear favorite to win the 200 meters dash. But sadly, just weeks before the competition, Johnson contracted food poisoning and lost great amounts of weight and strength. Johnson didn't advance past the semi-final round, but he got his redemption with a gold medal in the 4x4. In the 1993 World Championships, Johnson won gold in both the 400 and 4x400 meters relay. What was amazing about this competition is that Johnson split a time of 42.91 seconds, which is still, to this day, the fastest 400 meters split ever recorded. In the next World Championships in 1995, Johnson continued his dominance and proved why he was the best to ever do it. With gold medals in the 200, 400, and 4x400 meters relay, Johnson earned the first 200,400 double, and capped it off with the relay for the triple. That performance set Johnson up to succeed in next year's 1996 Atlanta Olympics. After running a time of 19.66 seconds in the US Olympic trials and breaking the American record, Johnson was set up for the 200-400 double in the Olympics, something that no man had ever accomplished. When he showed up at the Olympics, Johnson was given the title the man with the golden shoes due to his custom all-gold spikes. With a time of 43.49 seconds in the 400, beating second place by 0.92 seconds, he easily earned his first gold of the games. Later in the competition, Johnson lined up for the 200 meters dash. With a time of 19.32 seconds, Johnson won gold and broke the long-standing world record. This is one of the best performances in any Olympics we have ever seen by a sprinter, no doubt about it. In that 200 meters race, Johnson accrued a muscle strain and was out for most of the next season. Due to this, the IIF, which is the international governing body for track and field, made a rule that allowed defending champions to automatically compete in the world championships, regardless of qualifying. Although it wasn't explicitly stated, this rule was almost certainly for Michael Johnson, since he was unable to qualify conventionally. Johnson went on to win the 1997 track and field world championships in the 400 meters in Athens. In 1998, Johnson was part of the next world record-setting 4x400 meters relay, but two of his teammates were later outed for doping, and the record was reverted to the 1993 time of 2:54.29, which Johnson was also a part of. In 1999, Johnson was yet again plagued with injury. Thankfully for the rule established for him, giving the defending champion an automatic in to the championship, Johnson was able to recover and win his fourth 400 meters world championship medal. He also set a new world record 43.18 seconds, which stood for 17 years, until it was broken in the 2016 Olympic Games. In the 2000 Sydney Olympics, Johnson would take his last shot at the highest stage. Sadly, he would not be able to repeat his double due to injury. Johnson still ended his Olympic career with a bang, winning his last gold medal in the 400-meter dash at the age of 33. Also, even though the US placed first in the 4x400-meter relay, Johnson's teammates were again exposed for cheating, and Johnson willingly turned in his gold medal. A great way to look back through his career is through all of the Hall of Fames he's in. Here's the list. The Texas Sports Hall of Fame in 1997, the Baylor Athletics Hall of Fame in 2000, the U.S. Track and Field Hall of Fame in 2004, the U.S. Olympic Hall of Fame in 2009, and the International IF Track and Field Hall of Fame in 2012. No matter how you look at it, Johnson has had one of, if not the most successful athletics careers of all time. His incredible longevity matched with unmatched speed and performances is something only he has done. From incredibly humble beginnings when he was running with his siblings to the Olympic Games, Michael Johnson is the best to have ever done it. But here's where I turn it over to you. What do you think about Johnson? Do you also think that he's the best ever? Let me know in the comments down below. Please like and subscribe, and as always, thank you for watching.